Hey folks, welcome back to another astronomy video. So, little disclaimer before I start, this video is especially for owners of Newtonian reflector type telescopes. Specifically like the beginner's models that you will get for under like $300 or so, I would say. There seems to be an issue with these telescopes when you want to hook up a DSLR camera to it in a prime focus mode to do imaging. A lot of these telescopes won't focus with a DSLR in prime focus mode. So let's take a look what we could do about this, how we could fix it to make it focus with the DSLR. So I've got my good old Meat Newtonian telescope that I own since I'm like 10 years old or so out. I don't really use it anymore that much, so it's quite dirty and dusty and not in great shape, but still I'd like to modify it that I can take pictures with a DSLR, and we can maybe try at the moon tonight. I think it's a full moon, the weather's looking good. But first thing that a lot of people do wrong, actually, I think, is if you're working on your focus on your telescope in general, on the fine tuning, a lot of people tend to say like, yeah, I have to wait for a good night that I can set it and stuff, that I can see the moon or some stars. That's not necessary. Do it in daytime. It's much, much easier. And the point is, you see what you're doing. It's not pitch black around you, and you can just pick a target that's really far away, like close to the horizon. I think a few kilometers will do. Just a second to show you which target I want to focus on here. Really far in the distance there on the horizon. I think you can't see it yet. If I zoom in, there's an electricity pole. Wow, wait a sec. Ah, my cameraman skills are quite bad. I think you see it there, that really tiny electricity pole on the horizon on the hill up there. We'll take that as our test target. I think I'll try to show you what I see directly with the video camera. Here's the eyepiece. If I go really close, it's really shaky, but you see the farm building at least. I can't really see the light. Yes, I can see it, the electricity pole. I'll just put this on a tripod quick.
Yeah, okay, the tripod thing, it didn't really work out, but I hope you could see it before. Like the farm building and the electricity pole were more or less sharp. So we can do eyepiece projection if we put a camera, if it's the video camera or a smartphone, whatever, directly on the eyepiece. We can get images this way, but it's not what we want. We want to attach a DSLR and get this one to focus without any lens, without the eyepiece. We'll go directly to the sensor. So let's see how that works out.
So now we've got our DSLR attached and directly prime focus mode, it's really directly into the telescope, no eyepiece, no lens, and you see the picture, it's blurry, and this is like the closest I can go in with the focusing tube. If I go out, it'll get even more blurry. The funny thing is stuff in the foreground, like this leaf here, it's really close to the telescope. We can get that in focus. But stuff that's far away, we can't. That's our issue here. So basically, there's two solutions to this problem. There's like a quick and easy, but a little bit dirty fix. And there's like a proper clean fix. And I'll show you both.
So the first solution, the quick and easy, but a little bit dirty one, is to use a Barlow lens, something like this. This is my more expensive Celestron times 2 Barlow. This is some cheap plastic Barlow that I got with some cheap telescope. It's a 3x Barlow. They both work. I tested them both, even though like the Celestron one looks better. So let's see how to connect it. Actually, it's really easy. You just put it in between the DSLR and the telescope. I'll cut to connected mode.
So the Barlow lens is connected now. Tube got a bit longer, and let's see if we can focus on something here. And I'm still really out of focus. Something's coming. Oh, look, the forest. There we go. Oh, we're a little bit off for the electricity pole. Ah, there we go. And it looks kind of sharp. I hope you can see it in the video. Yeah, more or less. But I am able to focus now. This is cool. So, problem actually solved. But there is a downside to this method, because if you use a Barlow lens, you will have double the focal length. So I'm not even sure what kind of focal length this thing here have. 910 millimeters. So that would give us 1820 millimeters focal length. That's neat if you want to go really close to a target. But the downside is you'll lose half of your light intensity. So you will have to make longer exposures if you do deep sky, for example. So it's not really a clean solution. Also, your field of view will be half. Let's try a little bit more difficult solution, but the proper one.
So, as we've seen before, the problem is this tube here is too long. So if we could put our camera further down, we would be able to focus. The thing is, the more I turn this up, the more the camera comes up, the more blurry the image gets. So basically we have two solutions to solve this. First would be replace the focusing mechanism with a shorter one. I think if it would be like down here, this would be actually enough to get it in focus. However, I don't have like a focusing mechanism lying around. I looked at this one. I was even thinking if I like could cut it down a bit, but that seems too difficult and I could break something. So the second solution for this problem is the mirror back here. That's like the parabolic mirror. That's the main piece of your telescope. It's too far back. So if we can move the mirror a little bit up, that should solve it. So let's try how that goes. So I removed the mirror with only a screwdriver. It's only three screws. I know it can be like scary to take your telescope apart. Obviously it's not something you would like to do, but I just want to say, like, this technology is really old. It's called a Newtonian telescope because Newton, you know, the guy with the apple, invented it like 400 years ago, so it's really not high tech. And even if you're not handy with like tools and screwdrivers and stuff, it's possible. Like, just give it a try. It's really not that difficult. You can't break that much. You only have to do your fine-tuning the collimation again afterwards, which you should do anyway once in a while. So don't be too afraid. It's not that difficult. So what we have to try now is get this mirror further in. Like, we have this problem that it's limited to this distance, but I want it further up. So let's see if we can... Oh, look, there's even a spider living in the mirror. Maybe I'll give it a quick clean anyway. We'll have to disconnect this part from this part and bring it up a little bit. But first I'll only disconnect it and try to find the distance by hand. Just one little thing we should do before we start taking this thing here apart is to like mark the position of the mirror where it's now. And I'll do a really rough estimate. So, well, you could use a meter. Let's say, I mean, the tube will be here. And I want to go for the lower part of the mirror, like this part here. Here you can see it. I want to know where this position is. So we'll take this here, and I'll say it's roughly 2.5 centimeters in. It's really roughly, but I think it doesn't has to be extremely precise. So let's mark 2.5 centimeters on here. That's about here. Just that we know where we started from. Okay, we got the thing apart. It was also just three screws, really simple. Then you got these three feathers, these Springer things here. I'm not sure if I have long enough ones of these, but in the worst case, like, just forget about them. I don't think they're that important. Basically, we got three of these here out, these connected the thing. If we just find some longer screws with the same threads like this one, I think this should work. But before, I will just test it by hand. I'll connect the DSLR and then I'll like push the mirror in a bit more and out a bit more just to find the distance that we have to shove it in. Apparently it's really difficult to like have move the mirror by hand that you get a focusing position, but I think I do now. I'm not sure if you can see it, but here on the display there's the flagpole and the forest in the background. I'm trying to focus on the forest because that's where the electricity pole is. I think I have focus now, so I know how far I have to move the mirror in.
It's quite a bit. It's about
2 or 3 centimeters. So I'll do a mark here and then we'll see if we find longer screws. Just a small thing I forgot. Here I have like, I put the focusing mechanism a little bit out. Maybe I even should have gone a little bit further. You don't want it to be all the way in when you adjust the mirror. You want to have a little bit of play here just that you can do your fine focusing.
I think I found myself some screws, even though it's a Sunday and the shops are closed. I'll just have to work with what I got. These are a little bit too short. I would like them to be like a centimeter longer, but I think it works. Just to compare. These are the old ones. Already bad light. These are the new ones. These are like 3 centimeters and these are 5. Would be better if they're 6 though. But this just applies to my telescope. You'll have to find this out for yourself. So now, what we have to do, we took out the old screws. This here will come back together. And these springs here are more important than I thought. We'll have to find a way to connect to them, to press to them. I don't have any spring-a-ma-things in my shop, so we'll have to improvise here. I just put in the new screws just to take a look at it here. This looks quite okay. It's kind of straight. We'll figure that out later though. However, the problem now is really with these spring-a-ma-things. We will need a spacer to put in between because everything moves now. We need to get this stable and also we need these 3 screws to do the fine-tuning in the end. Also, one thing, there were like 3 more screws. They're still in here. I think, yeah, here you can see them. Do it better than me. Go to a hardware shop, get your proper screws and also replace these. Take longer ones here. I'll just leave these in for now because it's just a quick video, but yeah. Let's find some spacers for here. So I did manage to find some spacers. I'm just using these nuts here as improvised spacers. These are too big for these threads, which is a good thing because we want the screw to be able to turn to do the fine tuning in the end. So what we'll do now, just fill in these spacers. And we'll also put one of these round thingies, these donut shaped thingies on top that we can like press them against the spring of things here. So this will go together, put this one here. This will go together like this. I'll put it together and show you how it turned out. I think we're done. I just got everything together, was a little bit fiddly but it worked out. And yeah, now it's like 2 to 3 centimeters more up front. But really, like, wait for a week. They go to a hardware shop, get the proper screws. Don't do it as dirty as I did. But I think it works. Let's go back to the telescope, put it in, check it out. Okay, I reconnected the mirror, put it back in, put the 3 screws back on. Try to get it as straight as possible. I will have to collimate the thing to get the fine tuning precise, but I think I'll do that at night time and with a laser collimator. I'm not explaining you like collimation here. I'm sure there's a lot of good videos about that, but we have focus. Take a look. Again, I hope you can see this through the video camera, but it's in focus. Also, just to show you, this is now really not much space, but it should be enough to be able to focus. So, mission accomplished, I would say. One last thing I want to try out is if we still can do visual observing with an eyepiece. I'm not really sure about that, actually. Yep, it still works with the eyepiece. Let's try to take a look. Not sure if this here works out, but you see the farm building there in the background, and it's in focus. So that's really cool. You still can use it for visual observing, but now you can focus with a DSLR. It's finally gotten dark and the moon has risen. However, the weather situation isn't that great. It's quite overcast and hazy. I can show you the moon quick. Up here, I'm sure the camera won't focus. Now it won't, but yeah, you can see the clouds. However, I can see the moon here on the scope, and it's in focus. Yeah, I don't know how good this looks for you, but I'll just switch to the DSLR video mode and we can continue from there. So this footage now is directly from the DSLR. It's just in video mode and it's a lot of clouds coming in. I think this is like the last chance to get something, but it's really in focus, so our modification worked. And really, I just want to say, feel encouraged, don't be afraid, you can't brake too much, take the mirror out, put it a little bit up further and you'll be really happy with your Newtonian telescope. Before I'll end the video, I will do some pictures and I will put the best one really at the end of the video, so please watch it till the end. Just wanted to say I thank you for watching, I hope I could help out some fellow amateur astronomers here. And yeah, I wish all of you clear skies. See you soon. Bye.